Here is a big welcome for our eminent adjudicator, Ms. Anuradha Goyal. Ma'am graduated from GLC Mumbai in the year 2019 and is currently working as a legal manager with a retail litigation team of LTFS. Along with this, she keeps a profound interest in contract drafting and is passionate about social work. During her college days, even she was a core committee member of the Legal Aid and Material Vertical of IDIA Mumbai and Social Activity Club of IIT Bombay. We also have our faculty coordinator, Ms. Ridhipriya Gurtu, who is an assistant professor in Department of Law, Prestige Institute of Management and Research. This Prestige family is really pleased to have you amongst us in the event of National Debate Competition 2020. We are really excited to hear our participants and wish that this event leave the best remark in our memories. The room is ready. The tables are set. So let's begin the most awaited Padma Shri Dr. Anand Jain National Debate Competition 2020. Now, I'm relinquishing this house to Ms. Anuradha Goyal. And we had two participants. Participant 1, Dhruvi Shah, team code DAB05, will be presenting for the motion. And the second participant, Harshita Singh, DAB48, will be presenting against the motion. Now, I'm relinquishing the right of house to Ms. Anuradha Goyal. Ma'am, you can proceed.
Hi, good morning, Panishri and everyone. Thank you for the welcome. Can I request the participants first to introduce them in one line? Deb05 can start first. Just introduce yourself in one line.
Hi, I'm Dhruvi Shah. I'm from LG School of Law and I'm representing the motion from the government side.
And Deb48, can you please introduce yourself in one line?
Harshita, you need to unmute yourself.
Okay. Hello, ma'am.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning, ma'am. I'm Harshita Singh. I'm from Alliance University, Bangalore. And I'm a fourth year law student. And I'll be against the motion. Is medical testing, is free medical testing in India is justified or not?
Okay. So let's start. Deb05, can you start your further motion?
Sure. So the motion for today's houses is free medical testing for COVID-19 justified in India or not. So I as a government propose that it should be made totally free throughout the nation for a country like India. Now when we talk about making it free, the first thing that comes to our mind is the economy of the nation. This is surely going to affect the economy of the nation, but we as a welfare state thinking about it, this disease needs some special attention and care towards it. This is not a normal disease which is like relevant to like diarrhea or malaria kind of thing. This requires some kind of special attention to it. So that is why thinking of welfare state and thinking of the we need to provide it is our duty as a government to provide some basic welfare and health to the citizen of the nation. As when we think about making it free, the most important thing that will happen would be that the people who are scared for getting themselves tested just because of the outcomes of the tested, that what will happen if they get tested positive, or some people are also scared of getting themselves tested just because that they think that it might be a problematic towards their economic situation because of this lockdown. Everything is closed and there is no sector and business units working, and that is why it is possible that it becomes a financial issue to them. But when we provide this, it would be kind of a financial aid to all those kind of people, and that is
why. Ma'am, I would like to interrupt in between. I have one point of clarification. Like as she is saying, it is the duty of government to take the hello.
Yeah.
It is the duty of the government for the welfare of the society, but at the same time, the government should also look into the economic and financial condition of our country. Like, as we know, the people are dying because of coronavirus, and more than because of this coronavirus, people are dying because of poverty.
Dhruvi Shah, you can continue.
Yeah. Thank you. So coming to her point, I'll come to that later in the rebuttal, I guess. Continuing with my speech, I would say that the people who come under the low economic class, people who are a very easy prey to it, who can be easily target to it. So we feel that at this point of time, they also need to be feel safe. And that is why we are making it free for all the citizens throughout the country, because there are some generous taxpayers and the people who have generously donated throughout the lockdown through the PM CARES Fund and all other. So we think that it would be kind of a financial aid to all of the people around the country, and it is good to make the step. Again, coming to the testing thing, the testing would always going to be beneficial to the people because there is no harm in it. Getting it tested, we'll be confident on our numbers when we'll be having the number of cases in our hands. So we'll be confident to even make the better policies for the nation, to even ensure to make the rules of the lockdown, that we whether we need to extend it or whether we need to cut it down. So it would be a great step if we'll have the number of cases in our hands at once. Plus, it would be easier for the doctors and the nurses to work as when we have the numbers in our hands, and we have seen that it gets spread amongst the doctors and nurses only. So if we get them tested, it would be easier for us to operate. So that is why also it is easier. Plus, the people who have the symptoms would come forward easily by themselves without hesitating, because they need to understand the importance of getting themselves tested, because this is a disease which is really hazardous and contagious. It is directly related to the lives of the people.
Can I have one question?
Hello, let her complete her arguments, then we'll listen yours.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah, so continuing my speech, when I was saying that it is would be only beneficial in all the ways, because when they'll come forward, they'll understand the importance of getting themselves tested, because now they not only themselves, they'll also spread it to the other people and they can also get affected. So at this point, it is really helpful. Plus, thinking of the economy, now India is self-sufficient to make the testing kits by themselves. So, and we do not need to rely on someone else. That is also going to reduce the cost of making the test kit. At the same time, we can also get help from the PM CARES Fund, from the WHO funds, which we have gathered during this lockdown. So this makes much more sense to make the test free right now in this kind of situation. And as a government, I propose that the testing of the medical disease coronavirus should be made free throughout the country.
Okay, Deb 48, you can go for your arguments against the motion.
Ma'am, as my co-participant had already briefed you about the coronavirus, I would like to tell you that the government recently Supreme Court has made an order for making the free testing of coronavirus. But for that also, it is given to only a person who are under the public health insurance scheme and Ayog Bharat scheme, and only few percentage of people are left for the only few percent of people are left whom they need to pay this payment of test. So it is only 4,500, which is and for that China also paid has charged 370 yuan, which is equal to 4,000. And some CEOs of Thyrocare, the CEO of Thyrocare has given up data in public domain that the actual cost of test is 5,000, and government is imposing only 4,500, which in which the 500 is lacking, and for that they are paying this. They are not sufficient. And if you see that the current capacity of government hospital is they are doing at only 36% capacity, and the private labs are doing it on 50% capacity, in which 49 labs are there and 123 government labs are doing this. We can see that the pressure is on private companies, not on government companies. And the private labs is a profit making entity. It needs to make money or it will die out. So it is we are kind of pressurizing private companies, and it is kind of infringement of Article 19, right to business. So their business, their right of Article 19 has been infringed, and we can see that the testing kit it itself is 5,000 rupees. There is not much assurance over when government will reimburse the labs. And there is CEO of Thyro Care company with the CEO of Thyro company gave an data which is establishing the fact that they are paying much more amount to their staff and they are paying in advance only because the family of staffs are not allowed to their family members to work in that situation. So for that they need money. And the 2 points should be noted in that order. That order does not mean that anyone can go walk into the private labs and get a free test. It should be signed by a doctor. So it is not only few percentage of people need to pay the amount. And another one is the Ministry of Health and Welfare guideline. Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening. Go on.
There are only 4 or 5 guidelines which are given by Health and Ministry of Welfare, Ministry of Health. Like only symptomatic contacts of people would need to be testified, and and the people who have travel history and the infected people need to be testified. Not all people. So only the middle class of people can afford this 4,500 price. Is not much amount. So at the same time, we need to look upon our economy also. It need to be, we cannot go in debt. So, and we are making our self-grown kits also that will help our government as well as private labs. So, after some time, it will be, the amount of this 4,500 will be reduced automatically.
Okay, so time is up. So, now I want to seek a point of clarification from Deb 5 for the motion. You said that we have enough funds from the PM CARES and stuff. But what I want to understand is what about the future? If we utilize all our funds right now, what will happen in the future? The virus is not going anywhere. It is going to be with us for a long point of time. So what about that? If we utilize all our funds right now, what about the future?
Okay, so for answering that, I would say that this is a long time disease, I understand. But when we'll test all of the deaths, we will be having a number of cases in our hands that when we know that, okay, only this much of people are affected and the rest are safe. And we can fund, we can use our fund that wise. And this is an extra fund which we are getting right now from the nation, that is PM CARES fund and all, which is extra right now. Like it is not a part of the GDP or the part of the financial which was from the government. So it is not like we would go right now. Also, the economy is not in a great state. It is already in a bad state. But we feel that the lives of the people come first, and then the economy. If we'll not have lives, then what is the use of the economy? If we'll even save, or if we will not do. So what as government we feel is that right now testing would and making it free would be much more would be making much more sense, and we have enough funds to. Like afford and accommodate all of it.
Okay. Deb 48, I seek a point of clarification. You said that the middle class can afford paying this amount of rupees 4,500. I want to know, in the current situation, when there are salary cuts, layoffs, how can the middle class afford this amount of rupees 4,500? Don't you think it is justified on the humanitarian grounds that we make it free as a government?
Ma'am, it is justified on humanitarian ground, but the order of Supreme Court is impractical. For the private labs, they don't have self amount to fund their own employees. How can they do for this free? Like we see the WHO has given guidelines to do solution is to testify the people and quarantine them. For this, we need money, and nobody can pay from their own pocket. They have to people have to give their child. We can see one point that after the in between of lockdown, when we the government opened the alcohol shops, everybody is going there. 1,300 crore of government got this taxes, and they got funds from this alcohol shops only. So why they can't afford their testes? If they are affording alcohol at no, people are buying alcohol for 50,000, 60,000, even middle class family is doing this. So we can, why they can't afford their own test?
Okay. So, Deb05, you can proceed for your rebuttal.
Okay, ma'am. So, for the rebuttal's first points, I would like to tell her is that no lower middle class people can afford themselves even the luxurious items or anything, specifically the test, because they feel that, okay, even if one of their family members feel the symptoms, they still don't get themselves tested because they think that what will happen if I use this money in my test and what would happen to my family. Plus, when the government is being able to afford it, why not? Why not to make it free for all the citizens? When you said about the private sectors and the private labs, the labs that are working to the 50% of their efficiency, there is a point when government can talk with the private hospitals and make a kind of a deal with them by making something. But that is not a way. And even private labs cannot. Just a second.
I would rebut her argument. Let her complete. You'll get a chance, definitely.
Yeah. So continue. What I'm telling is that you cannot say that private labs are working at the 50% efficiency, so the people should go there, because private labs are charging. And the point over here is to making the test free, just because people are not being able to afford. And even if the middle class family who are whom about you talking can buy alcohol and all, not all are being able to afford, and we are not right now at that stage that they will bifurcate them, that okay, who are being able to do it and who are not being able to do it. Right now, as a welfare state, we think that for all of the people of our nation, it is a generous step towards to take towards it, and that is why we are making it free for all the people. And when you said why can't they pay for it and go for it? But why do they need to? This is not like anyone's fault that Corona has come, and just because they are middle class and just because they are earning, that is why they need to pay for it. It is like in this lockdown, no sector is working. Even if the people who were having the jobs, they are not having their whole salaries to themselves right now. So that for a step in this lockdown, it is sensible to make it free for all the people throughout the nation.
Okay, I would like to rebut this. Like you said, it should be free for all. If it is done, even for a mild cold or something like that, people will go to hospital. It will increase the crowd, and it will be there will be more chances to spread this virus. And for this, the government hospitals, all the tests are free. Even in private hospitals, the people who are under public insurance scheme, this test is free. The people who are under Arogya Bharat scheme, this is free. Only few sector of people which are paying this fee. So only, I think it will be only 10-15%. For everybody else, it is free only. So for 10-15% can contribute their part in to cover economy. It is also our own duty to help our private sectors also, because how can they live if we don't have food to eat? They also have their own family. They also need money. So how we can just ignore them because they are doing this public so-called public duty? I know this is humanity against humanitarian, but this is private job. They are doing for their own benefit. This is a profit making company, not a public sector. Government is doing for this for the public. It is not duty of the private companies to do this public work. We cannot rely on private charity completely to come out from this international epidemic. So
am I allowed to answer?
I think we are done with this now. I have marked you. Both of you were really good. All the best for your results. I have marked you accordingly. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now I request our faculty coordinator, Ritupriya Gurtu, ma'am, to deliver a vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all. I especially thank the participant, Harshita and Dhruvi, and our Anuradha ma'am for coming and adjudicating this debate competition. We will again be joined by you, Anuradha ma'am. So it would be again a pleasure for us to have you again in the next session. Dhurvi and Harshita, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
Both were good. I mean, it was really good to hear, to listen to your points of argument. You both will have to wait a little bit for the result. And special thanks to Yati and Poonjri for organizing and chipping in for this debate competition. We will update you with the result in a moment, in a while. Thank you from Department of Law, Prestige Institute of Management.
Thank you.